brick and mortar. Hey folks, how you doing? This is Bill. It's a couple of days after I found that silver 1700's coin right over here. I'm standing in the cellar hole right here. And you can see how it slopes downward. And this is the mound right here that I'm hunting. I remember the day I got the silver 1700's coin. The first target I did was the right here. And I remember digging down when I was home and digging this piece up and almost like forcing it up for maybe an entire base over here. So I'm just gonna clear this little section right here and see if there's anything under there, like maybe the original fireplace or something. I just want to see what's under there. I'm gonna skim it off the top, just put the dirt in one pile for now and see what happens. Okay, so if you remember, this is the spot where I pulled out that piece of brick with the mortar attached to it. And when I was lifting it, it sort of felt like it was coming out of a fixed structure. It just didn't feel like it was thrown down here loose. So I felt like I ripped it out of maybe where it was, the base of a fireplace or something. So in digging it, just digging a little bit, I found these two side by side. They're still mortared together. Then I just dug a little more, and it looks like there is some kind of structure here. So I'm just gently peeling off the top, and a little more over here. These are lined up. So it looks like there is some kind of formation to this thing. Maybe this was the fireplace over here. I'm just gonna, like I said, skim off the top real lightly and see what's underneath here. And this is the cellar hole right down here. And when I first got here, I mean, there was bricks thrown all over here. They were loose on the top. So I threw them back down in the hole over here just to put them in one area. But just in skimming this, the top of the ground here, looks like it's uncovering something. We'll see what comes up. I'm gonna give it a light scan with the detector right now. Keep the nickel signal. Keep the nickel signal in. Next time I come, I'm gonna bring a screen and take all this, slowly run it through. See if you notice, you notice this mound has very few high tones, because I have picked this mound clean over the last how many hunts. Sure, looks like a good signal in there. Now. Mm-hmm. that roofing tin, I'm pretty sure. Okay, yeah, so square nails like crazy in here. Signal back here. See what's in there. There's a little bits and pieces of that roof sheathing. So I'm going to run all this through like a quarter inch screen so the dime sized coins won't slip through. And just take it real nice and slow. Yeah, found this the other day. That's an oldie right there. I mean, if it's some kind of a rake, it's not bent, you know, claw like they are today. This is just straight. But I don't know, depends on what kind of tool it is. Probably got a brass ring around it. With a wood handle, it would have had. Okay. And these are some of the bricks that I found in the beginning on the top. They were probably right close to the fire. You can see that burnt emerald green when the flames constantly hit it. It's that old brick. So like I said, I'm gonna scrape off each layer very gently, a little bit at a time, and I'm going to screen each section of dirt as it comes up through quarter inch screen. I'm going to take it real slow. I'm not going to dig this. I'm going to just, like I said, one little layer at a time with a brush, and be very gentle with it, just so you know, not to disturb anything that might be there. And we'll see where it leads. So this gentleman came to America in the late 1600s, and he worked in the area and bought this land in the very early 1700s. This was his first home site, and he raised his family here, and him and generations after him stayed on this property from the very early 1700s throughout the 1800s. The late 1800s, 1890s, is when the last family member was living on the property, and then no one since. What I don't understand is, and what intrigues me about this mound, first of all, the reason I started digging this mound is, like I said in my earlier video, that I wanted to just pick a small section of ground and just stay on it. So I chose the south side of the house because it had full sun all day, and I figured if they were doing any kind of work or chores or anything outside during the day, they would be doing it on the south side of the house where they'd be getting full sun. So that's why I chose this 30 foot in diameter section, and it sits right next to the cellar hole right here. And like I said, it's like a mound, and so as I hit it last year, whenever it was, and I found those two British coppers back there, they were both 1700s. One was a 1723 and the other one I couldn't identify the date. Then later on, a couple of weeks ago, I found the third British copper right here, and then the 1787 silver right there. What I'm not understanding here is why this mound only held 1700 coins so far. If this family lived here throughout the 1800s, why didn't I find any 1800s coins mixed in also when they were sitting out here and working or doing whatever they do? Maybe they were in there and I still haven't found them, I don't know. But another thing I thought about is that this mound, and being that it is a mound, you can see it's lower, the landscape is lower over there. It appears to me that this mound was taken out of the cellar hole here by somebody in later years who was digging it, maybe a little deeper, and just threw it up over here. And I think maybe that's why this mound isolated 1700 coins and no 1800 coins, as if they were working out here and dropping coins throughout those centuries. Only four 1700 coins. So I'm thinking this dirt isolated those 1700 coins in that time period. And I'm thinking possibly in that cellar hole. So whoever dropped them, maybe they were in the cellar hole at the time in the 1700s, and he dropped the coins there. And then in later years, early 1900s, some guys came over here and just threw all this dirt up here and formed this mound. And along with the dirt came the 1700 coins that the guy dropped back in the 1700s inside this cellar hole. So that's the reason I'm continuing this thing, and I just want to screen this whole mound and see, because I also want to see what else is in the dirt. Personal items, like a pocket knife or something like that, that he might have dropped when he dropped the coins inside the cellar hole. Something that can give me a further clue where he was or where this dirt was when the coins were dropped in it. And so, like I said, I think this dirt, not having any 1800 coins in it on the outside of the house, on the south side of the house, is to me strange, because there should be 1800 coins in there if people were working and living here throughout the 1700s and 1800s. But that's what makes me think that this dirt came from somewhere, and I think inside that cellar hole, and they were dropped in that time period in the 1700s. So we'll see what happens. We'll see what else I find in the dirt. And then this way maybe I can get an idea that where the dirt along with the coins came from, what part of the property and things like that. Just trying to get a better understanding of the whole thing. In the meantime, this looks like the fireplace or something over here. I found ashes in here also. And we'll see what comes of it. I'm just running the pinpointer through these little mounds of dirt before I leave. As you can see, this is all iron, square nails. Right over here, I was getting a signal. More of that roofing. I found a few of these clips. And just some kind of clip. Some of these the other day, just like that. I don't know what they are. Just leave me here for now. It's got like a nickel signal. It'd be a little button or something. Yeah. Tiny little button. Look at that sucker. That is so delicate, man. Wow. I can't see if there's any writing on it. Little nickel signal. Maybe like a cufflink button or something. Nice if there's some kind of writing on it. I think there might be some kind of design on it. Let me check it out when I get home. Okay. There she goes.
If you're like most women, probably 10 or more, especially around the waist. If this sounds like you, it's not your fault.
Okay, this is it all cleaned off. I'm glad the shank didn't break. Shank's still there. I saw some kind of design on it, like a cuff button or something. Let's see. Whoa. I know what that is. That's the Order of the Masons there. That's Masonic. Yeah, that's the compass and the rule, the trowel and the pyramid. Wow. And he was one of the first to settle in this area. Straight from England. Yeah, this guy was a big boy, alright. Revolutionary War. In the military. I'm definitely gonna check this out.